Hello everyone, this is Tanya from Professor Tanya Speaks, and today is going to be a short video. Fingers crossed. I just wanted to just jump on here and just give you some reminders as many of you college students prepare for final exams. I know it's a stressful time for everyone, and the first thing I want to tell you is you really should try to not beat yourself up if you're just starting to prepare. If you start late, unfortunately, it happens. But if you spend too much time being angry with yourself and beating up on yourself, studying is gonna get harder. So accept it. Yeah, I should have started earlier. I should have, I didn't. But now I'm starting, let me see what I can do. So that's the first point, forget blaming yourself and throw away the guilt. Life happens, especially now in these times of COVID. I tell my students to celebrate the fact that they're still in school, because for many people, there are so many other stresses. There are so many other concerns. For some people, they've had to pick up more shifts at work because, you know, maybe some members in the family have lost their jobs, so more is being expected of them or being demanded from them. And you do what you need to do to survive. The fact that you're still in school, celebrate that. And let's just work on some strategies now going forward. So that's the first thing, don't stress. The second thing is that you need to observe the 8-hour rule and make sure that 8 hours before the exam, you are not studying. Those 8 hours leading up to the exam, make sure that you're relaxed. That actually is one of the strategies. Be relaxed and get some sleep, because if you do, then you'll be better off in the exam and you'll be able to remember more. But if your brain is tired, you'll go in the exam and you may just freak out. It happens all the time. So remember, be gentle with yourself. I know this is not the type of thing that the professor says, but it's true. Be gentle with yourself. We've all, even as professors, instructors, teachers, we've all done last minute studying and we've all survived. I'm not saying you must, but if you do, don't blame yourself and don't be hard on yourself. Remember in this video, I spoke about failing for 3 years. We fail too. So be gentle with yourself, okay? So 8-hour rule, get enough sleep before the exam and forget about Red Bull. My sons were really good with the Red Bull. Forget the Red Bull. Okay, so that was one, that was number two. Number three. Now, when you do start preparing, remember some of the strategies that I spoke about in this video and this video. Space repetition, Pomodoro technique, keep them in mind. Active recall. I won't go through them again, but what I will tell you is that you need to study and walk away and come back and walk away and build and build and build and quiz yourself and see what you know and what you don't know. Apply the Feynman technique. Do all of that, all discussed in these two videos. But don't try to just sit and cram. Cramming doesn't work. It really doesn't work. Even if you have, let's say you have 4 days before the exam, you can still use these techniques very slowly. Do a little, take some time off. Do a little, take some time off. Active recall, okay? So remember, all of the active recall strategies, those will help. Another thing is also try doing some mind maps, as I discussed, I believe, in this video. That helps you also to remember and to see what you know and to see where the learning gaps are. Because the thing about this preparation time is that as much as you can, you want to be trying to recall, not just reading. Because if you're just reading, that is not useful. Reading alone will not help you to remember in the exam. So practice recalling from now. And speaking of practice, try to see if you can get your hand on old past exams, past paper exams. That will also help you to see how prepared you are. So try to locate past exams and see what you can do. It helps. It really, really helps. And speaking of past exams, the next tip I have is be sure of the format of the exam. Will it be multiple choice? Will it be essays? Will it be short answer questions? Will it be fill in the blanks? Be very clear about the format. You don't want to go in the exam and be surprised when you say, oh my God, I didn't know we're gonna be asked to write an essay. So be very clear, ask the instructor, ask the professor. And speaking of essays, my next tip is, if you have to do essays in the exam, don't just begin writing. Plan your essay first. Professors, instructors, TAs, we are tired of essays with no point. Plan it first. And forget about the 5-paragraph essay. Nobody wants that anymore. Maybe in high school that was okay. That's not acceptable anymore. And try to avoid the thesis statement that everybody expects. Try to be original. Give us something fresh. That's what we're looking for. Wow us and make us say, wow, this person is reading. Okay? So, if you have to do an essay, make sure it's a well-written essay with your thesis statement, with topic sentences for each paragraph. But make sure it's a thesis statement that is not overdone, and, you know, make it as novel as you can make it. And don't stick to the 5-paragraph essay. Think, and show us that you're thinking. Another thing is study in reverse. So the last things that the instructor did in class, start there and work your way back when you're preparing. Why? Because it's fresher in your minds, 1 and 2, more than likely, the areas in the syllabus that were covered earlier will not be covered in as much depth in the exam because you've already more than likely gotten assignments and maybe quizzes already. But the things that came later in the course, which have not yet been reviewed or tested, you can bet that those are going to be on the exam. So study in reverse. You got to be smart, guys. Study smart. You can't study everything, but study smart. Another thing is, if you were keeping track during the semester and you notice that the instructor or the professor seemed to really like a particular area and kept talking about it, that's coming on the exam. Look back at those parts. So whatever you thought was being highlighted and emphasized, look for those and really hone in on those parts. I think I've told you all that you really, really need to know. And I think more than anything else, you have to remember to be confident in yourself. Understand that you have all that you need in order to do well, but a lot of times it's the self-doubt and the negative thoughts that keep us down. That's actually important, that you train yourself to be less negative. Don't compare yourself to your classmate who always gets A's and always seems to be prepared. Do you and be you. That's always a good thing. Be you and do you. So I think I've told you everything that I think you really need to know. But more than anything else, spaced repetition is very important right now. More than it was ever important before. Give yourself a chance to integrate the material. Don't just be forcing everything in. Give yourself a chance. Do it. Walk away. You know, take a nap if you want, but maybe not go on social media, because if you go on social media in between, you may not remember to come back to studying. But give yourself a break and be gentle with yourself. So guys, good luck in your exams. And no matter what the grade is, it is not an indication of your self-worth. Keep that in mind. It's good to get grades, good grades, and you want to get good grades, but don't use it to measure who you are. And remember, even if you fail, as I spoke about in this video, even if you fail, it doesn't make you a failure. But if you keep failing, there may be a lesson that you need to learn, as I discussed again in this video. So be good to yourself, be gentle with yourself, study hard, but be gentle with yourself and be aware of what's happening. Look at yourself, look at how you're reacting. If you're finding that something is really not working for you, dig a little bit more deeply and try to figure out why. Good luck in your exams. Keep safe during these COVID times. And you've come to the end of the semester, so be proud of yourself for all that you have accomplished. And when it's all over, put school behind, register for the next semester. Don't take up another book until January. And good luck in your studies as you continue, if you continue. If you're now going to be searching for employment after, good luck with that also. Have a few videos on resume writing and cover letters. If that can be of some help, please use the resources. And until I see you in the next video, bye for now and good luck.